Sarah Gideon wants to raise your taxes but doesn't pay her own. On the Freeport Town Council, Gideon voted to raise property taxes every year. At the same time, Gideon's family business wasn't paying theirs. Sarah Gideon, you pay, she doesn't.
It all started with one of these. You remember those days? I pressed that blinking answering machine button and heard a message left for my husband, Ben. It said they knew he was probably too busy with work.
I mean, look at what I've accomplished. Do you see him?
But would he consider running for the town council? I thought to myself, actually, I think that's a job I can do. And somewhere I could make a difference. So I ran for that office.
Oh my God.
He's been on the town council as a state representative or as main speaker of the house. And when someone tries to get in the way or get me to back down.
Uh-oh, I know that look. She got the crazy eyes.
I like that she has her little pictures that she's holding up.
I'm Susan Collins, and I've approved this message.
Working people depend on our cars and trucks. And in my budget, every dollar counts. Higher fuel taxes hurt Maine workers, our farmers, and our families. Maine can't afford Sarah Gideon.
So you're probably wondering, Lily, what's going on? What's going on is because I have been living in Maine. I am not a Maine resident. I am a New Hampshire resident. But I've been living in Maine since March. I have been bombarded with nothing but Susan Collins and Sarah Gideon ads. And quite frankly, I am fucking over it. You know, sometimes I just want to sit down to eat dinner and listen to Wheel of Fortune that's on the TV, or I don't know, Jeopardy, because I'm 95 years old at heart. And all I hear is Susan Collins is bad for Maine. Susan Collins is a county girl, and she's like, the county girl ads are literally my favorite.
You can take the girl out of the county, but you can't take the county out of the girl.
Like, they're literally my favorite. And Sarah Gideon is a pretty poor politician. Okay, I don't give a shit about either of these ladies, quite frankly, because I am not a Maine resident. I care about New Hampshire because that's where I'm at. I mean, obviously I care about the whole like country and shit like that, but these two ladies are literally in the midst of a political catfight, and part of me was living for it at the beginning, but now I'm just like, oh my God. Like, right now I have such a headache, but I wanted to just put this out here. I am so over both of these women. I'm almost just like, don't vote for either of them because they both are just petty bitches right now. But then I love how like everyone's just like, Susan Collins is a county girl. And then the next one will literally be Susan Collins is up Trump's ass with a freaking microscope.
When the men in the Senate were terrified of Joseph McCarthy, she called him out. Just like Susan Collins stands up to Donald Trump. Oh, wait. Susan Collins never stands up to Donald Trump.
And it'll be that same loop of her saying, I vote to confirm Judge Kavanaugh. I vote to confirm Judge Kavanaugh over and over and over again. Oh, God. You know, quite frankly, neither of them seem right for Maine. It's just been something that's been bugging me. And I wanted to share that with you because, like, I mean, I already voted, so I feel pretty good about that, personally. You guys know I don't get political on this channel. I try to avoid politics as much as possible, but this was just, it's just too much. It's just too much. I'm sure in other states you guys are feeling the same way with certain political ads, but it's a lot. I just wanted to make this brief little video. Airplane. Yep, there it goes. Who do you think will win? If you're a Maine resident, who are you voting for? Are you voting for Gideon? Are you voting for Collins because she's tried and true? Or, you know, like, what's going on? How you guys feeling? I can't vote for either one, so my opinion really doesn't matter when it comes to either of them. But it's just a lot. It's a lot. And just this catfight seems endless. I'm like, if this is what you're saying about each other in your political ads, what are you saying behind the scenes? I can say that I have shaken the hand of two politicians. One was by accident. One was just like a, what the hell, why not, maybe. The first one was, I have shook Joe Biden's hand. That did happen. He had just recently been announced as Obama's running mate, and he was in the New Hampshire area, and my older sister and my older brother were like, hey, we're going to this rally, Joe Biden's gonna be there, do you want to come? And I was only 17, I couldn't vote. I turned 18 like 3 weeks after the election, but I was like, yeah, sure, okay, why not? So I went, and after his like speech and everything like that, he would go around and like shake people's hands, and I was right there. So I was like, okay. And I shook Joe Biden's hand and that was literally it. And then I went to a really one of the bigger fairs that happens in New Hampshire and Maggie Hassan was there. I didn't know Maggie Hassan was going to be opening this fair. I went with, I was working for a cleaning service at the time and it was just something that they always do. They go to this fair as like a group, as like a work group. And so I was like, yeah, sure, okay. I wanted to get to the arts and crafts tent. Like where there was this big tent with a whole bunch of arts and crafts and Maggie Hassan was literally standing in front of it. And I was like, I need to get around her because I didn't give a shit about Maggie Hassan. I don't care. Like I wanted to go look at arts and crafts for God's sakes. I got like swept up with these other people and she thought I was waiting to shake her hand, but I really just wanted to get to the arts and crafts. And yeah, I ended up shaking Maggie Hassan's hand and I was like, okay. I just want the arts and crafts. Don't thank me for my vote because I didn't vote for you at the time. And I just want to look at some arts and crafts. I want to look at some handmade picture frames and weird dolls and quilts. So yeah, that's Lily's history with meeting politicians. Oh no, I served another politician. He was running locally last year. I can't remember his name, but he would come into the restaurant where I work quite frequently actually with his wife. I think I voted for him. I don't remember. I honestly don't remember. I've never liked a politician enough to want to get a picture with them. Except if Obama, if I met Obama, you know, I definitely want to get a picture with Obama. Honestly, how I feel is that I voted, so I feel like I should stop seeing these political ads because I've done my literal civic duty. The most important civic duty that I have done. I want to stop seeing political ads now.
Susan is a county girl.
Yes. Bobby Newport wants you to just hand him this election. Don't.
I won't.
Please, I'm done. I don't feel good today. I don't want to see these. That's just me whining. How are you doing? I'm doing okay. Work's been a challenge because it's all new. And I'm just kind of overwhelmed at the moment. Yeah, it's been a lot. It's been a lot. And I'm trying to be as self-motivating as possible and not fall into bad old routines of doubting myself. But it's very difficult. That's how I've been doing. How are you? My little rant about all of that. Not even so much a rant, just like, oh my God, can we just have the election now, please? I just want it to be over. I just want it to be all over. I'm sick and tired of it. I think a lot of people are. That's my little video for today, my little Friday update. And yeah, thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned and turn on for more.